I'll show you my version of a hot Italian girl makeup tutorial. She has great appetite and is not afraid to eat and doesn't count calories. She is smart and reads smart books. And of course, in her head, there are only smart thoughts. And yes, of course, she argues. She argues very passionately, like all Italian people. But it still sounds like music to the ears. So I start by applying a powder to my skin that's been moisturized, of course, beforehand. And if you've seen my previous makeup videos, you will recognize this powder. It's a baked powder by Pupa. Pupa. And Pupa is an Italian makeup brand. So it totally makes sense because a lot of Italian women actually use this powder. Then I'm going to apply just a tad bit of concealer around my eyes, a little bit the inner corners of my eyes. And this concealer is lightweight because we do not want any, you know, cakey, heavy makeup. No, no, no. This is Italy, it's hot there, so we need everything to look sensual but natural. Then I'm blending it, starting with, you know, the right finger, which is the ring finger, since it's the weakest finger and it cannot, you know, stretch the skin around the eyes. But then I forget and switch my fingers. It's important that the concealer is blended really well into the skin, and I'm not applying it all over, you know, the skin underneath my eyes, just at the inner corners, just to brighten my look a tad bit, because without it, I think the makeup will look just a tad bit dull. Then I'm trying to fix my eyebrows by applying a bit of a dark brown powder. You guys, I should never block my eyebrows when I'm angry or when I'm excited. I always ruin my eyebrows. And my eyebrows right now don't even look like my eyebrows. I've ruined them completely. I hate doing it, but I never learned my lesson. So I'm just trying to make it look normal, because eyebrows are very important since they frame your face. I'm going to apply castor oil every single night to my brows so that they grow faster, because castor oil is best when it comes to hair growth. Definitely try it with your lashes, with your eyebrows, and even with your hair. You will see results very, very soon. Then I'm taking my bronzing powder, which is again by the Italian brand Pupa. Pupa, 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 Pupa. Blow in the excess off the brush. I'm applying it to where the sun would naturally hit my face, with this very gentle strokes, hardly touching my skin. really like to have a natural effect when it comes to bronzer. Although, if I'm not mistaken, this is the same bronzer that Gorgeous Hottie used in her video. Then, I'm taking this brush and look what I'm doing. Can you see that I'm doing? Doing that movement? Because that is also where the sun naturally hits my face. You have to be a bit careful doing this because we do not want to look as if we got sunburned. Just a tad bit, you know, tanned. We just stayed a tad bit longer in the sun. Then I'm applying it also on my forehead a little bit. This, I think, gives life to the skin because the powder, it kind of, you know, evens the skin tone completely. Then I'm taking this illuminating powder by Shiseido. Very unique product because it makes your skin look polished. And again, I've used it in my past makeup tutorials as well. And it's going to act as my eyeshadow base. Although, you should wait and see what I use as an eyeshadow. Some people who've seen my makeup videos before, they will remember this trick. And so, for eyeshadow, I'm taking my bronzing powder. A little bit on my brush with natural bristles. And there you go, applying little by little. To use brushes with natural bristles for powders because natural bristles, they pick up powder formulas really well. And for liquid formulas, you should use synthetic brushes. There I'm trying to apply it, creating, you know, this effect of cat eye. I really like that look. Not overly drawn, like not a cat woman kind of a cat eye, but just pulling the corners of the eyes a tad bit higher. And using the bronzer that you used on your face as an eyeshadow, it also is going to look really nice with the rest of face, the rest of your makeup, because you're using that color lightly on your face, right? So, I'm doing the same thing on the other eye. And I always like to apply a little bit and then build it up rather than to apply a lot and then have to blend it, because it can end up looking like dirt, you know, like I'll give you a muddy look, which we do not want, because when you blend too much, that's the kind of look you can actually get. And if you're attentive, you'll see that I'm really blending only at the edges of where I've applied this eyeshadow bronzer in this case. Not all over it, just the edges. That technique helps you get a more precise look, a more precise eye makeup, because eye makeup, it takes some time, even if it's very simple. Then I'm taking the same brown shade as I used for my brows, and And just to give a little more depth to this look, I'm applying it on the outer corners of my eyes. And as you can see, I applied so little because it's quite concentrated. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going just to blend it a little bit, just to emphasize the look, and as I said, to give it just a more deep effect, you know. It will still look very natural, so you shouldn't worry about it. Doing the same on the other eye. And blending really well. And that kind of looks okay. Let's now just use a little bit of the lightest shade on my lids. It's not white, it's a cream shade. So it will look very natural. It's basically the color of my skin. And now it's time for liquid liner. Actually, I like to apply the liquid liner on top of an eyeliner pencil. That way it's much easier to get a precise line. But at the time I didn't have an eyeliner, but now I do. I bought one from MAC and it's very good. Checking to see if everything is symmetrical. And it's time for mascara. I don't know why I'm so excited about putting on a mascara and why I'm making that. Actually, it's really hard to apply mascara without making funny faces. Very hard. But I'm trying. And by the way, this technique of applying mascara, I picked it up watching makeup artists do makeups of some actresses. And it really helps to get separate lashes, you know, if you want to get that effect. And there you go. I think we're done with the eye makeup. Now it's time for the lips. And as always, before applying lipstick, I'm going to be applying a lip liner. I don't know what I said. I love red. And along palette, I'm going to create these fairy lips. Of course, I have to use a blusher. Just a really nice juicy color, a tad bit on my cheeks. This is by Lancome and it's a tester, but it's lasted me for years now. I love it. Checking. And I think it looks fine. So, here's my interpretation of hot Italian girl makeup with bare lips but very natural skin, who has a great appetite. Can you, by the way, guess what I'm eating? It was so refreshing and tasty. Not only Italian women should read and know about Leonardo da Vinci, but I think only the Italian people can actually argue and still make it sound as if they're just reading a very passionate poem. And so I hope that you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to put a thumbs up And of course, click the notification bell so that you don't miss